Good morning. Following the president's vow to assist the fight against Ebola, the Korean government will send an advanced team of officials to the Ebola-stricken regions. Dialogue between protest leaders and government officials to end the weeks-long demonstrations in Hong Kong is to take place today. Will a consensus be reached? Better pelvic alignment could help you to better posture and overall health. Get a doctor's opinion on posture. And again, we have Alex and Oliver's urban camping experience right here in the capital. That's on Korea Today, Tuesday, October 21st, 2014.
From Arirang News, this is Korea Today.
And good Tuesday morning. Thank you for joining us on Korea Today. I'm Kim Young alongside Kim Min-jung and Oh Jin-ju.
Good morning. The Incheon Asian Para Games enters its fourth day today. And yesterday, along with many other games, wheelchair dance sports took place, and Korea was able to sweep all three gold medals in yesterday's competition.
That's right. And we mentioned yesterday it's the first time the wheelchair dance sport is being introduced in the Para Games. And there are two types of wheelchair dances. The first type is when both of the dancers are on wheelchairs, and the other one is where one person is sitting down and having the other dancer standing up and assisting with the dance. And they can dance to waltz, tango, samba, and of course, cha-cha-cha.
You know, I wish we really did have like the videos instead of the stills, because you can actually see the movements.
Oh, it'd be so beautiful.
Yep, and see how graceful it is. It actually originated in 1968 in Sweden, and it was originally for rehabilitation and recreational purposes. And then that's how it became a sport.
Shall we try some?
I
can't. This thing moves.
I cannot tango, samba, or any of that, so we'll have to put that away for another lifetime, right? But for now, we'll jump to our top story for this morning. Korea is responding to the ongoing Ebola epidemic in Africa and will dispatch an advanced team to the Ebola-hit West African countries early next month. A group of 6 to 7 officials from the Foreign, Health and Defense Ministries will visit Sierra Leone and Liberia early November to assess the situation in the affected countries. Following the advanced team, a group of volunteer medical personnel will be sent to the region. This move comes after President Park Geun-hye vowed to lend support to global efforts to contain the spread of the deadly virus last week. The details were confirmed in a meeting on Monday. In addition, Korea has pledged to contribute $15 million in the global fight against Ebola. The United Nations has been appealing to the international community for further aid in containing the epidemic, which is estimated to have killed more than 4,500 people.
President Park Geun-hye has called on the international community to narrow the global gap in information and communications technology in order to improve the welfare of mankind. Attending the global conference of the International Telecommunications Union in Busan on Monday, President Park underscored the need to tackle the growing digital divide while also laying out Korea's plans to introduce 5G technology, the next generation mobile network.
2017년까지 기가 인터넷 전국망을 구축하고 2020년 세계 최초 5세대 이동통신 서비스 상용화를 목표로 기술 개발과 인프라 고도화에 박차를 가하고 있습니다.
Now on the sidelines of the plenary session, the World IT Show, the country's biggest ICT exhibition, will take place, showcasing the latest technologies touted by leading global tech giants, including Samsung Electronics, SK Telecom, and Qualcomm. Various cultural events will also be held during the three-week conference that ends on November 6th.
The Korea Land and Housing Corporation announced that it will be opening a research center dedicated to testing apartments and buildings for inner floor noise by 2018. Now, this project will be funded jointly by the Housing Corporation and the Ministry of Land, Transport and Infrastructure, and established in Sejong City and the country's central region. It will also include testing for indoor air quality and ventilation. This follows continued disputes and lawsuits between neighbors living in high-rises in the country, which begin with inter-floor noise. As the noise pollution issue grew more serious in recent years, the Korean government and civil sectors began actively seeking possible solutions. In a bid to contain the escalating noise disputes, authorities have decided decided to toughen rules against noise pollution and implement a program that fines rowdy residents.
A roadmap to attain global targets set to preserve biodiversity by the year 2020 has been adopted at an international conference on biological diversity, which came to a close last Friday in Korea's eastern city of Pyeongchang. Also notable about the gathering this time around is that it served as an opportunity for Seoul to win support of its vision to create a peace park in the demilitarized zone along its border with North Korea. Korea Today went to Pyeongchang to cover this global conference. Take a look.
A meeting to promote biodiversity and raise awareness about sustainable development was held for 3 weeks, starting September 29th. In the eastern city of Pyeongchang, Gangwon-do Province. A total of 20,000 people from 194 countries attended the conference, the 12th of its kind, called the Conference of the Parties to the Convention on Biological Diversity, or COP. It won attention from both local and foreign media as its largest gathering so far. Other meetings to discuss biodiversity were held in parallel with the COP, the Biodiversity Summit for Cities and Subnational Governments being one of them.
Subnational governments are tasked with conserving biodiversity more so than national governments. That's why we hold the meetings together. The Biodiversity Summit is to promote cooperation between the local and central government as well as civic groups in order to work together to preserve biodiversity.
Cooperation between governments at the national and subnational level is crucial in conserving biodiversity. That's why the summit has been held in conjunction with the COP since its 11th meeting.
We are dependent on biodiversity. We're dependent on the planet's living system for producing almost everything we need for maintaining a good life: food, water, clean air, and also an environment. For me, it's very clear that biodiversity and the living systems are at the core of sustainable development.
The summit this year was co-hosted by Gangwon-do Province and ICLE Korea. ICLE stands for International Council for Local Environmental Initiatives, known as the Local Governments for Sustainability. It emphasizes the role of subnational governments in environmental conservation. Currently, 45 local governments in Korea are members of the organization.
I think it's very important that this meeting occurs in Korea and that Korea is becoming more and more a model that challenges the world on energy efficiency, on maintaining biodiversity, on all of the aspects of building a sustainable society.
The local government plays an important role in getting various people to actively participate in policies related to biodiversity. I hope the meeting can show people how closely the issue is connected to our daily lives.
At this summit, discussions were held on what local governments should do to help countries implement the Convention on Biological Diversity. Gangwon-do Province, where the conference took place, is home to 21% of the nation's forests. This is why it can be considered the center of Korea's ecosystem. Some local government officials from other countries who visited Korea to attend the summit made a trip to the Demilitarized Zone, or the DMZ, which is the most significant ecological area in the province.
Here you can see five little islands, and those are still part of the Kumgang Mountain. The road in front of you is the way to go to the Kumgang Mountain, and we're not able to use this.
The DMZ is a strip of land cutting across the peninsula between the two Koreas. It's 248 kilometers long and 4 kilometers wide, with a military demarcation line running down the center. It's the only demilitarized zone in the world. Civilian access has been heavily restricted since the Korean War came to a halt roughly 6 decades ago. This is why, with its pristine nature, it has become a symbol of biodiversity.
Both North and South Korea government should come together, have some collaboration to make this DMZ ecological conservation zone rather than DMZ.
I think it's very important to recognize that this is a heritage, to understand that peace is necessary. These zones are very interested for wild animals or for plants because they don't care. They don't care about borders, right?
Meanwhile, at the Biodiversity Summit on the 16th, the Gangwon Declaration was adopted, becoming a key achievement of the COP. The declaration includes calls for international cooperation to prevent the extinction of biological resources.
With the Gangwon Declaration, the Korean DMZ and Baekdu Daegan, once recognized only as assets to this province, have been declared as assets of the world. It states the area should no longer be considered forbidden grounds, but a symbol of peace and biodiversity that should become an accessible resource with practical use in the future.
The Gangwon Declaration was passed on to the United Nations after the conference, and it will be put on the table for discussion to determine whether it should be adopted as a development project after 2015.
Good morning. It's time to run through the front pages of your newspapers. Now, a variety of issues on the domestic papers today, including what's called the Lincoln Law or the False Claims Act, which is an American federal law that imposes liability on companies or individuals who defraud governmental finances. Now, they're trying to make a Korean version here in the country, so we'll take a look at this headline here on Dongwaeilbo. And it says government to demand compensation from five times worth the profits made on unlawful spending of state funds. This is the Korean version of the Lincoln Law, as I did just mention. And taking a look at the subheadlines here, this law is a primary tool used to combat fraud against the government in the U.S. And it is often referred to as Lincoln Law because it was passed under the administration of President Abraham Lincoln. Now, Korea is looking into creating this law as well, so that it can be applied in the case of unlawful use of national finances. Now, in such cases, the government can redeem all relevant costs as well as receiving five times the amount of illegitimately made profits by firms through punitive damages. The government is planning to submit the bill to the National Assembly this coming December. Meantime, the public officials' pension reform bill has been the talk of time, has been the talk of town for some time now. And this article is titled "Plans to Pass Public Servant Pension Reform Bill in April Under Review." Now, this past Sunday evening, the government and the ruling Saenuri Party, they met for a closed-door meeting to discuss the public officials' pension reform bill as well as plans to pass the bill. And it says in the article, that it was the first such meeting between chairman of the Saenuri Party Kim Woo-sung, Prime Minister Jeong Hong-won, and the President's Chief of Staff Kim Ki-chun. The high-ranking officials were examining ways to pass the reform bill with the agreement of the rival parties during the extraordinary session of the National Assembly this coming April. The ruling Saenuri Party had initially planned to pass the bill by the year-end's regular session, but it has been postponed to allow for thorough negotiations between the ruling and opposition parties. Now turning to Joseon-ilbo for a look at this headline on the side. This one's on a beautiful piece of art that has been found, and this reads, "First octagonal lacquerware from Goryeo dynasty discovered." And this is actually a very rare art piece from the Goryeo era, which has been discovered in Japan at an art exhibition there, which is believed to be a masterpiece from the 14th century. Now, it's this piece right here in this image, an octagonal sutra box, a first of its kind ever discovered, and it's one of the Najeon Chilgi art pieces, which is Korean lacquerware inlaid with mother-of-pearl decorations from the Goryeo dynasty. And finally, we'll turn to some business news on the Korea Economic Daily. And this one is, the title says, Foreign firms say employment regulations hinder investment drive. Now, taking a look at the sub-headlines, Yesterday, it was one of the things that the foreign companies said at a meeting presided by Prime Minister Cheng Wonwan. The heads of foreign investment firms here in the country made various suggestions to the Prime Minister, including the legislation of the ordinary wage system for foreign companies. Now, the meeting was organized to stress Korea's push for business sector deregulation, in which Prime Minister Cheng vowed Korea would continue to improve the business environment for foreign firms to help them grow side by side with local ones. And that was a look at our local headlines for this Tuesday. Now, following are the stock numbers from Monday. Now, the day is off to another rainy start this morning, and something tells me that things will get a lot colder after this rain.
Yeah, it seems that the mid-autumn rain is going to bring that chill right afterwards. But for now, it's supposed to rain pretty much for the most of the day, including into the evening. So we'll get a check on the weather conditions with Chun Song Cho, who joins us from the rain. Good morning.
Good morning to you, Song Cho.
Good morning, guys. Yes, the rain continues today nationwide. It's drizzling over here in Seoul at the moment at 15 degrees Celsius, but the mild winds are making it feel a little bit chillier. Seoul and the greater metropolitan area will receive about 5 to 20 millimeters more rain before slowly subsiding tonight. In the meantime, areas in the Chungcheongdo province are facing the greatest amount of rain, where 120 millimeters of additional showers are forecast until tomorrow. The rain can turn torrential at times, pouring down at 20 to 30 millimeters an hour, so people in the mountainous area should take extra precautions. Coastal regions may also be affected with strong, gusty winds accompanied by thunder and lightning. Now, if you're thinking you want all of this rain to go away as soon as possible, you might want to think twice, because after the rain, much colder weather conditions are in store for us. With that, let's take a closer look at today's temperature readings. Temperatures won't fluctuate much throughout the day. All the cities start this morning at lows hovering around mid-teens, even in the upper teens in the southern regions, but the highs remain around 20. This is all for me with the weather forecast. Back to you, Minjung.
And yet another hopeful development in the Ebola epidemic. The World Health Organization has announced that Nigeria is officially Ebola-free. For more on this and other global stories we're following at this hour, we'll turn things over to our Eunice Kim, who's standing by at the news center. Good morning.
Good morning, Minjung.
Now, Eunice, tell us more about the UN health body's conclusion.
Well, there hadn't been any new cases of Ebola reported in Nigeria recently, and in fact, the WHO waited a full 6 weeks before they announced on Monday in Abuja that, in fact, Nigeria had contained and eradicated Ebola. This is clearly a hopeful development for the fact that it shows Ebola can be beat with careful monitoring and coordinated containment. There was a lot at risk, as Nigeria is a densely populated country and home to Africa's largest economy. Lots of lessons to be learned from this case, not least of which is that health officials quickly identified the original contagion, a Liberian-American government official, and also swiftly traced and quarantined those he had come into contact with. WHO officials, though, say the war is far from over and won't be over until the rest of West Africa is declared Ebola-free. Help has been pouring into the region in recent weeks. More than 500 American soldiers are building treatment centers in Liberia, as army medics from the UK are supporting treatment centers in Sierra Leone. Cuba is sending more than 460 doctors and nurses to West Africa, the largest contingent of foreign medical professionals to fight the epidemic in West Africa. And Hong Kong's High Court has handed down injunctions being reluctantly received by the pro-democracy demonstrators who were ordered to clear out. They were awarded last night to two taxi associations, a bus company, and an investment company, all of whom had argued the sit-ins had lasted too long and were proving to be a public nuisance. The orders affected roads in the districts of Mong Kok and Admiralty. Student leaders said it was up to the individual to choose to stay or to leave. This as expectations of a breakthrough were low ahead of a dialogue that will launch today between protest and government leaders to end the weeks-long demonstrations that have blocked traffic around the territory. Eyes are also on the fourth plenum of China's Communist Party, currently underway in Beijing. We'll be watching whether leaders address the unrest in Hong Kong as they grapple with this year's theme of rule of law.
And in the meantime, the world's third largest democracy, Indonesia, has sworn in its new president, who really represents a rags-to-riches story himself.
Absolutely. In some ways, Joko Widodo is only Indonesia's seventh president, and unlike his predecessors, who all came from the military or political elite, he literally had begun in the slums of Java, growing up in a rented bamboo shack by a river. The 53-year-old took the oath of office for president on Monday in Jakarta in front of hundreds of members of parliament, as well as top foreign delegations, including U.S. Secretary of State John Kerry and Australian Prime Minister Tony Abbott. Now, in his inaugural speech, the former furniture salesman turned Jakarta governor said it was time to realize an Indonesia that has political sovereignty, economic independence, and cultural character. For all the optimism surrounding his inauguration, though, political watchers say enormous challenges await Widodo in his five-year term, including fierce opposition in parliament against his economic and political reform drive. With that, we'll wrap your look at the global headlines we're following this morning.
And still to come, if you're interested in improving your posture and your overall health, maybe start thinking about your hip and whether it's properly aligned. We bring you some interesting workouts for pelvic alignment and look at why it's important with a doctor in the studio, so don't go away.
It's funny how every time someone says the word posture, you just sit up straight, just like that, inadvertently, right? Now, with the Busan International Film Festival coming to a close, there are many films that were screened over the past festivities, but there are some movies that are out in theaters now and are going to be out in theaters, which have been sort of quiet, but now they're about to make some noise, and our Immune joins us with more on that. Good morning.
That's right. Good morning. So the Korean movie industry this year saw the huge success of some historical dramas, but that's not to say the other genres have been producing some notable works as well. So today I have a couple comedies that are going to catch your attention. Take a look. Two brothers are separated as children. One sent to America, one stays in Korea, both not knowing if they'll ever see each other again. And 30 years later, their paths somehow cross once more. But this time, they're adults. Sang-yeon, played by actor Cho Jin-woo, is now a pastor, and Ha-yeon, played by Kim Sung-yoon, a shaman. But despite differences, the brothers team up to find their birth mother, who recently disappeared. Created by veteran director and screenwriter Chang Jin, We Are Brothers is a comedy about teamwork and brotherly love, set to debut later this week. Now, Chung-woo is a movie director for adult movies, but he dreams of someday working as a regular commercial film director. That's when he meets the beautiful commercial film actress Eun-soo, who's been in the field since she was a child. The two start working together, and after they get to know each other, Chung-woo discovers drastic changes taking place in his life. The romantic comedy was directed by Park Pum-soo and features actor Yoon Ge-sang as Chung-woo and actress Ko Jin-hee as Eun-soo.
Sounds like a couple of big-time movies there. I mean, if you can see right behind us, these two actors, they have acted in, before in a movie in another very big hit called The War Against Crime, or what is it, the 범죄와의 전쟁.
That's right.
And they were pretty big there, and now they've come together in their own leading roles too. Now, let's talk about the movie Red Carpet. It looks like a movie for more mature audiences, per se. Is it safe to say that?
Right, right. So it is not something you want to take your kids to. It is rated for audience members 19 and over, and that's for the adult content. But the director, he's very young, but he's been showing some excellent talent, as along with a very witty humor, sense of humor. And so that's another movie that has been receiving some good attention. We'll have to see how the public receives it.
Okay, let's go back to the first one real quick again. Zhang Jin, the director Zhang Jin, he's been very successful these days.
Exactly.
Tell us a little bit more about the film and what we can expect.
So he actually took a 3-year hiatus, and this year he came back first with the movie High Heels and now with the movie We Are Brothers. Now, this is the 12th feature film of his works, but all of his works are very, you know, highly anticipated because he really does produce great works and people really respect him in the field for everything he does.
And we can't leave out Cho Jin-woo. He played very crucial character in Roaring Currents.
The Japanese feudal lord, so he was known for that. But both movies really feature some top-notch actors. And so, you know, you really want to keep an eye out for these comedies, although one romantic comedy, one just straight-up comedy, but both are going to be great movies to catch on a day like today.
Well, definitely. I will be out there trying to watch some of those movies as soon as we do get some time off. Well, thank you very much for joining us.
You're very welcome.
And still ahead on Korea Today, we're going to be continuing on with our guest house experience. Remember last week, we took the guest house experience under the stars in a camping setting. An urban camping setting is what we saw on a rooftop in the bustling mega capital, Seoul. Alex and Oliver bring you more adventures from their guest house experience with a challenging camping cook-off along with new friends. More on their urban camping experience coming up on Korea Today.
Now, yesterday at the ITU Plenipotentiary Conference, President Park unveiled plans to introduce the fifth generation wireless system.
That's right. And this 5G is supposed to be way faster than the current 4G. And I was thinking 4G is pretty fast, too. I'm happy with 4G. We'll find out more with our Seo Mi-sorang joining us right here in the studio. Good morning to you.
Good morning, guys. Right. So as we mentioned in our headlines earlier, Korea is aiming to become the first country to roll out commercial 5G services by the year 2020. So let's see what it's about. 5G. So the aim is to reach 1,000 the speed of LTE or 4G. So we're talking 100 gigabits per second. So what exactly does this mean in real life? Well, it means that you can download your favorite movie, the highest quality, in less than 1 second. And stuff seen only in sci-fi movies will become the daily norm, such as hologram displays and 3D video calls. And we are getting there. Just last week, Samsung set the industry best when it clocked 7.5 gigabits per second in stationary tests.
Less than 1 second in downloading
a full movie.
That's like literally a blink of an eye.
Exactly.
Yeah. I know.
So, you know, I think in the future it'll take longer time to actually choose which movie to download than actual downloading.
Exactly.
And, you know, when we say the year 2020, it seems like a really long time, but it's actually only about 5 years away.
No.
You're right.
So very
putting
soon.
Things into perspective there.
Now, staying on the tech theme, here's another homegrown development. Scientists, they've come up with a new type of electronic circuit, and it looks like this. It's transparent, it's flexible, and it stays on your skin like one of those, band-aids or stick-on tattoos. But because it's an electronic circuit, you can use it as a sensor to, say, monitor your vital signs or even as a display screen once you hook it up to some lights. Some fancy stuff there. And switching gears, Group Beast, they've launched a new song yesterday. It's called 1230. And soon after it was released, it ranked number one in all the major music charts here in Korea. Members were very happy. Leader Yoon Doo-jun, he tweeted, "I'm on cloud nine." Lee Ki-kwang also tweeted, "Thank you so much, I'm touched." Meanwhile, Yong Jun-hyung, he Instagrammed this screenshot of a music chart that has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 Beast songs in the top six. So they're sweeping the charts.
Aren't you a big fan of Beast, Sinjin?
No.
Oh, you are?
Okay, never mind.
She's not.
Okay, interesting.
And lastly, wrapping up, KTO, or Korea Tourism Organization, they've launched a new app yesterday for the Chinese tourists visiting Korea. So it's basically a guidebook in an app. So there's a lot of information on shopping spots, tourist attractions, restaurants, hotels, museums, and so on. There are over 6,000 entries, and there are also coupons as well that you can use to get a bargain deal. And the best part is that the application is free, and you can download it both on Apple's App Store and Google's Play Store.
These days, you don't need a travel guidebook, or you don't need to carry it around. Yeah, all you need is your phone, just clicking away.
And the great thing is that it links to the location service on your phone, so that you can use it as a GPS.
Wow. Well.
So two in one.
Okay. Thank you so much, Ms. Oran.
You're welcome.
All right, that was a look at some of the keywords trending online. I think some of our viewers, those with a discerning eye, might have noticed my posture these days
has gotten better. There is a secret behind this good
posture.
And we'll find out in Health Trend in a bit.
With growing interest in good posture, especially in the hips, a variety of books on pelvic alignment are out on the market. Not only that, there are also undergarments to help with hip alignment.
Hi, I'm Ashley, and I'm actually sitting on one of these things called hip aligners. And your hips are actually one of the most important body parts to take care of when you're maintaining a good health.
Just by using this device on your chair, you can expect better results in posture correction. I also heard there's an interesting workout to assist with hip alignment, so I paid a visit. It looks kind of like a dance, or just like people are walking on the spot, but it's actually exercise for the hips. The routine does not simply involve moving the hips from left to right. There's also bending the body back and realigning the hip by moving the pelvis and knees in a zigzag motion.
So do you think this dance routine has an effect on your hip alignment?
When I do this exercise, it realigns the pelvis and helps me lose weight, so I feel like my overall body looks more fit.
It's not only great for hip correction, but also dieting purposes, making it a more attractive option.
Just by moving your pelvis, you can expect significant results. This is because normally, you don't move your pelvis that much, so just with a little bit of movement, you can see the effects.
Pelvic realignment is getting a lot of attention, and we'll look at why it's so important.
So good posture is in, and you were saying that discerning viewers must be able to tell, or they must have known that your posture changed. And the secret to that posture change is actually...
Are you going to make me do it?
It's actually cheating. So
cheating? I mean, you saw it in the report briefly.
Exactly.
It's the pelvic alignment, a little help from the secret chair, in fact, right here.
Okay, so just get a little peek at that.
It's in hot pink, too.
But posture is a very important factor of life. It can really keep you healthy in many different ways. So we're going to find out a bit more about that with Dr. Lee Seung-min joining us. And she is from the Kyunghee University Korean Medicine Hospital. Good morning, Dr.
Lee. Good morning, Doctor.
Good morning.
Thank you for joining us. Now, we've heard that the pelvic alignment is so important in our posture and also with the diet and losing weight also. Why is the pelvis so important?
Well, the pelvis is made up of three bone structures, and it acts as a connecting bridge between the upper and the lower body. The balance of the pelvis can be broken in different directions, such as horizontally or even front and back. And each distortion can cause different kinds of problems.
So what exactly causes pelvic misalignment? Is it inevitable?
Well, aside from the congenital anomalies, the main reason is basically bad posture. Nowadays, people spend most of their time sitting down, and along with lack of exercise, it can cause the muscles to weaken and make them more vulnerable to distortion. It can happen to both men and women, but women tend to have problems because we go through natural changes of the pelvis during puberty, pregnancy, and childbirth. As for prevention, good posture, exercise, and if necessary, medical treatment are all important.
Well, it seems like that's exactly how that thing works. You know, it keeps your pelvis in line and thus affecting your whole overall posture.
I feel good.
your posture is fabulous,
I think,
though.
It affects your mood as well. When you're in this posture, right. You feel confident and you feel good. I like that.
Okay, well, I'm going to be trying that the natural way, right? But so apparently misalignment in the pelvic area up to a certain degree, it affects everyone, right? Mm-hmm. But how bad does it actually have to be in order for it to require treatment?
Mm. Well, as much as we would like to keep our body in perfect symmetry, it is nearly impossible to do so due to aging, daily activities, mm-hmm. or even small habits that we do without thinking. Just like many other health problems, the important thing is whether it's clinically significant and require medical treatment. There is no absolute standard.
Things like crossing your leg might affect your pelvic alignment, right. I'm imagining, right? Is there a way you can self-assess whether your pelvis is misaligned?
There are many ways, but a simple way is to lie down on your back, relax your arms and legs, and see where your feet fall naturally. Hmm. If one foot droops further than the other, there's the possibility that your pelvis is misaligned.
Mm-hmm. All right, so basically put your feet down, lay down, naturally in a comfortable state, and if one foot is longer, I guess that is something that you might want to look at. Now we're going to look at correction options. If you do see or if you do suspect a little bit of pelvic misalignment, then of course you must see a doctor. But what are some of the treatment options? Let's take a look.
If your hips are severely out of alignment, it can actually lead to arthritis. I'm a little worried about myself, so I'm going to get a checkup and see how my condition is. First, a test is carried out to analyze your current state. It looks at the front, back, left, and right of your pelvis in three dimensions to determine the balance condition and identify any problems. And to my surprise, my pelvis is misaligned. Doctor, I didn't think my hips would be so out of alignment. How serious is this?
At the moment, the pelvis is protruding quite a bit. This happens commonly if you have a bad posture when you sit or if you wear high heels a lot. And it can cause pain in the waist, hips, and knees, or it can lead to plantar fasciitis on the bottom of your feet.
I was prescribed with medicinal acupuncture that uses purified venom from a bee sting. I also received Chunha treatment that stretches the muscles, ligaments, and tendons surrounding the pelvic bone. The loud noise from it was a little alarming at first, but it came with a relaxing sensation. The results are quite visible, but it's important to continue receiving the treatment regularly. There's also therapy for pelvic alignment. Have you heard of the Schroth method, which is used for realigning the pelvis? It was originally designed to strengthen the muscle for those with scoliosis. It helps correct not only the spine, but also distorted pelvic structures, which helps greatly improve people's postures.
Okay, so I just tried this workout and it looked pretty easy from afar, but it's a little harder than I thought it was gonna be. But I think I'm definitely getting a workout.
There's also a hip exercise that's becoming more popular, which requires the use of a sling.
It's a lot of work, but I think it's helping strengthen the pelvis.
The workout tries to dispel the force of gravity and strengthen pelvic muscles that have become weak. By deliberately getting people to balance themselves, it helps enhance the core muscles.
The sling exercise creates an imbalance with the straps, and as the body tries to balance itself, it stabilizes the waist and pelvis. By doing this, it improves the spine and overall body shape.
I also heard there's another interesting exercise for pelvic alignment.
Hi, doctor. What is that you're doing on the floor right here?
I'm doing my pelvis walk.
Sit on the floor with your legs straight, then grab your feet with your hands. The next step is to move forward with your knees straight, but it's important to try to keep your knees closer to the floor. Move forward like this, and then grab your knees when you're moving backwards.
If you continue doing this pelvis walk, it can improve coldness in the lower abdomen that you get from inadequate blood circulation. So it can help treat eczema, rashes, psoriasis, cramps, and irregular menstrual flows that you get from persistent coldness in the stomach.
Let's all make healthy hips by trying out these hip aligning methods.
Right, shall we give it a try?
Right. Only if we can grab our feet in this position.
That's right. It's hard. touching your toes.
Right, exactly. Yeah,
that's the hard part. Right? Now, this pelvic walk, experts say that it helps your blood circulation in the lower part of your body. How is this possible?
Well, aside from connecting upper and the lower body, the pelvis also acts as a protective shield for internal organs and parts of the circulatory system, such as arteries and lymph nodes. And misalignment will alter the position of these structures and slow down circulation.
Mm. Right, we saw the sling treatment. Now, it's a little bit difficult to understand how exactly that treatment is going to help, right? But can you tell us, explain a little bit technically so we could understand in layman's terms?
Well, the main effect of the sling exercise lies in the strengthening of core muscles. The core muscles is a group of muscles located fairly deep that keep the body stable and balanced. The positions in those exercises force your body to use those muscles and try to keep balance. However, you need to be careful because if you have no to little muscle strength to begin with, it might cause further distortion or even create new symptoms.
Is this similar to like the way Pilates works?
There are similar actions in the Pilates as well, so I guess it's related.
Okay. Well, are there any simple exercises that people can do at home without the sling and all, and just simple steps that people can do to correct
the pelvic
their
walk?
Mm-hmm. Right. Aside from the pelvic walk,
there are many, but I'd like to introduce one. It consists of lying down on your back with one leg up in the air and slowly bending and stretching your knees while using
easy.
A towel to keep it in place.
I can do that.
It's fairly easy and safe even for beginners.
Okay, all you need is really a towel.
Yeah, exactly. But Minja, you don't need to do that. You have perfect posture now.
Now with a little secret help underneath my butt.
All right, well, Doctor, thank you so much for your time and joining us and explaining exactly what the pelvic alignment and misalignment can do to your body. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, your pelvic posture is certainly very important in your golf swings when you are playing golf. And what do you know? We are going to kick things off in golf and in the LPGA, where Korea got the good news on Monday that they'll host the 2018 LPGA International Crown. Now, the biannual international competition, which kicked off for the first time this year, will have Korea as the first nation outside of the U.S. to host the International Crown. Mike Wan, the commissioner of the LPGA Tour, stated that the nation was an easy choice to host the event, considering their long support of the LPGA. Meanwhile, Spain won the inaugural International Crown earlier this year, with Korea finishing in third place. And now shifting over to the 2014 Incheon Asian Paralympic Games. Now, South Korea dominated in the bowling competitions at the Asian Games, but it seems like it's the same case over in the Asian Paralympic Games as well. Now, after winning four gold medals in bowling on the first day, Korea adds three more gold medals in the two-person competitions on Monday. Now, so far, with 7 out of the 12 bowling competitions being played, Korea has won all the gold medals as they surpassed their previous goal of winning 5 gold medals in the sport. And now moving over to Game 2, the first round of the KBO playoffs between the LG Twins and the NC Dinos, as the LG Twins have a 2-0 series lead after their big win on Sunday. But unfortunately for the fans, the game was postponed due to rain on Monday and will be made up later today. And now we're going to finish things off with more baseball news here, but over to Japan, where former Samsung Lions closer Oh Seung-hwan is making a trip to the Japan series in his first year in Japan with the Hanshin Tigers as he awaits Lee Dae-ho of the SoftBank Hawks to advance as well. And the decisive Game 7 of the series between the SoftBank Hawks and the Nihonhan Fighters on Monday, Lee Dae-ho goes 2-for-3 with an RBI double in the 8th inning, helping SoftBank win the game 4-1 and advances to the Japan series. And now with the Hanshin Tigers and the SoftBank Hawks squaring off for the championship, Korean fans await as they hope to see the battle between Lee Dae-ho and Oh Seung-hwan. And that's going to wrap it up for me. This has been SJ. Have a great rest of the day and see you guys again for your sports needs.
So on last week's House of Guests, we got a taste of urban camping with two bachelors trying to pitch a tent, but struggled.
They actually did okay, but struggled in some parts, right? And this week, Oliver joins us with his story. Good morning, Oliver.
Hi.
Good morning.
Thanks for having me over. It's really nice to be here. Yes, I've been in Korea for about 4 years, but I would never have thought there'd be like urban camping. So it's really, really great experience to do that. So,
So you don't see things like this over where you come from, right? Even me from the United States, we don't really just camp out on the rooftops of LA.
No, I haven't really heard of the experience before, no. So.
Okay. All right, let's check out your experience then.
That's cool. Alex and I went in search of a unique guest house experience. It was smack in the middle of the city. We were greeted by a full set of tents, and it was a race to pitch one of our own.
And you won.
And you won, right?
Just, I think so, just about. And what captures our attention after the long, exhausting day?
Wow.
It's a rooftop barbecue. Yeah.
That's Ginger's favorite.
Really?
Hello.
It's a must when you're camping. The smell,
Who
the smell
are you
is
guys?
Beautiful.
My house guest.
Oh.
Yeah, from Hong Kong.
Oh, really?
From Hong Kong.
Yeah.
Nice. And you're staying here?
Yes.
Oh, very nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
So you're staying at the guest house too.
Yeah.
Celia.
Natalie. Nice.
Celia, Natalie. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
You gotta get rid of the wood chips. Because you get like you get that. Yeah, maybe. I don't know. I saw somebody do this before.
So yeah, as we enjoyed the food, the company, and with our new friends, the meat disappears pretty quick.
Mm-hmm. I'm really hungry.
Special한 걸 좀 준비해줄게.
오,
기다려.
So what is he going to cook up for us?
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it was all just instant food, so we were a bit miffed as to what was going to happen.
Is it real?
Yeah.
If I eat this, I will be full?
기다려봐, 이걸로 최상의 이 호텔에서 맛볼 수 있는 라따뚜이를 만들어주겠어.
From a hotel?
Wait, yes. He's going to cook up something.
With instant food?
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, so dumplings, chicken wings, pork. So it's all pre-packed goods that go into a pan.
Putting it all together?
You know, our producer is actually pretty good at stuff like that. He'll cook up some mean stuff with some leftovers.
It's surprising what you can do. So like ham and then cheese, kimchi, all added. Basically, it's kind of like an omelet.
In the end, you don't know what it is.
Like, you don't want to explain.
Right, the plot thickens.
It's going to taste good when it all comes together. I'm not sure, we'll have to wait. Is it going to taste good? What do you reckon?
기대해요.
무슨 말씀
모르지만 기대해요. You're afraid.
Yeah. I think we all are. 이거 뭐야?
And out comes sort of a new creation. So.
Kind of like a pizza, Chicago pizza of some kind. With eggs instead of the
and
cheese.
And kimchi inside.
What is it?
He said it was a ratatouille.
Okay. But you never know. It's some of those creations that become the hit makers and become the it spot.
Oh, gave a thumbs up there.
It was really good. It did.
Was it really good?
Yeah, surprisingly good, yeah. So Alex was fully appreciating the taste as well. So it's his. So this new camping food trick inspired Alex and I to take on our own cooking competition. So we paired up with our new Hong Kong friends.
Black fire.
To see who could make the best dish.
Purple mustard.
All right.
Ooh, yes. Purple mustard.
So the race is on and there's no turning back. We have to grab, you know, what we
whatever's
could.
There.
What
are
could,
you guys
yeah.
fighting over there? Kimchi?
I think I put too much water in that one.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I teamed up with Celia to make spicy rice cakes infused with sort of corn soup and topped with processed crab meats.
Tteokbokki.
Huh, yeah. I don't know about that.
those corn soup brings the consistency.
Yeah, it makes it a little thicker, especially when there's that much water in there.
Now that's kind of gross.
Yeah, it looks bad, but it tasted really good. Alex and Natalie, so it was like fried dumplings, beef porridge, topped with cheese.
Maybe you're an easy person to impress, Oliver.
I don't know about that. 완성됐어. 일단 우리 다 같이 먹어보고, 우리 K군이랑 저랑 이 맛으로 공정 정정당당하게 평가를 하고 오늘 아쉽게도 이렇게 탈 뭐 이렇게 진 사람들은 오늘 여기 다 뒷정리하는 걸로. 오케이.
Okay?
Yeah.
Yeah. Deal.
So clean up these, right?
Yeah. Okay. 시식하도록 합시다.
The moment of truth.
So which camping dish will win?
They're speechless.
This one, I'm sorry.
Oh. Oh. Yeah, it's better. Helps my
advice here. Disappointed. It's hard to believe, but Alex's team won the cup.
Cream cheese Monday, we know. Oh.
So, thank you.
Oh. After I tried it myself, I had to admit it was pretty good.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm really interested in your corn soup mix.
That tastes good too. It's, you know, it's hard to go wrong. All the ingredients themselves are nice, so it's hard to go wrong, isn't it? You know?
Really?
So yeah, we were left to clean up after that though. So, yeah. Sad for us both. And then while we were cleaning up, we could hear a sound. So it's a group of street performers who come here basically to, they perform there regularly before they go out busking.
Uh-huh.
Mm. So really nice finish to the day.
Oh.
Come on.
Missions.
Aren't you a DJ?
Come on, for real?
You guys should come down, have a seat.
Guys, show us.
The song is really good.
DJ's different.
Yeah. It sounded really good from up there, but we didn't get to see it.
Well, of course not.
We're too busy cleaning. Uh-huh.
Well, you should have cleaned faster.
We cleaned pretty quick.
You should have cleaned faster. Very Alex of him to say.
Yeah, he's a good laugh, Alex. So yeah, the guest house offers a space for everyone who's interested in having some fun to kind of sit down and just enjoy with like new people and get involved.
Not bad at all.
Mm.
It's really nice.
저희도 원했는데 뭐 할 수 있는 거 있으면 하나 보여줄 수 있어요?
그냥 아무거나 나는 프리스타일 가고 비트 하면 이거.
아무것도 아무거나 제가 할 수 있어.
Fighting the beats?
I'm trying. It's either that or clapping. Clapping gets a bit repetitive after a while. So yeah, the night continued. We went on to the early hours. And then the next day, with a new day, comes a new mission. We landed our new destination and a final competition. So, we were wandering around and more coming up on that next week.
Mm-hmm. All right, it looks like you visited an antique store looking through some old LPs,
yeah,
right?
There's so much stuff there. It's really hard to choose and to try and think of, you know, what to give, you know, to with the budget we had.
Yeah. So a nice rooftop barbecue under the full moon. It seemed like a perfect date. Did you enjoy yourself?
Yeah, it was really great. It's so nice to, you wouldn't really expect it in a city. Cities can be quite busy and then all of a sudden, like, you know, camping, if you go camping with your friends or your family, you kind of chill out, you're bonding, you know. Mm-hmm. Forget about the stresses of, you know, whatever. So it's really nice just to be able to do that in the city, really.
Yeah. Okay, so we've been talking a lot about the food and how unique they all are. Which would you recommend? Let's say you would recommend one of those instant food dishes to make. Which one would you recommend to our viewers?
I think you just go with the judges. Choose the one that won. So, like, yeah, I guess the mandu with, you know, the rice porridge and cheese. They're both really good though. It depends what you're into.
Still on the fence about that one.
You guys have some really creative ideas with such random ingredients. How is it cooking outdoors?
It's all right, you know. Most of the stuff is just, you know, boil it. For us, the tteokbokki, just boil it up, stick the flavorings in. mix it, make sure it's all warm, all the cheese is melted, and then you're good to go.
So. Mix it with corn soup.
Yeah. You had a bit too much water there in
yeah,
the
I did,
pot,
yeah.
right?
Mm. Yeah, I was looking for the on the tteokbokki thing. I was looking for the water level, but
your tteokbokki is not supposed to float in the soup.
It was swimming around there. It was quite happy.
You have to push the tteokbokki out.
More soup goes in.
Try to make it thicker, yeah. maybe. Yeah. All right. Well, you had the beatbox performance as well, which we're very impressed with. And you're a DJ. Tell us about your DJing experience in Korea and also how that all came together with the new friends that you made.
I don't know, DJing is very different to beatboxing because DJing, you actually manipulate stuff with your, you know, your hands and stuff. But so just, it's very different. But, you know, DJing in Korea is really fun.
Okay, so that's what you do. That's your work over here
that you do here. Yeah. And,
Where can our viewers go to see you?
A lot of places.
You at a just, club?
A lot of places.
You can, yeah, check on my website.
So what time's your set and on what days?
Weekends, only the weekends.
Yeah. Weekends?
Let's go to one of those clubs.
Well, sounds good. Can you get us a table with a free bottle?
I'll give you
my
number later. You can come. Yeah, I'm sure.
Okay.
All right, sounds great. Thank you very much for joining us, Oliver.
Thank you so much. All right, well, this is where we say goodbye on this Tuesday morning already.
And once again, just like yesterday, a rainy one it is. Drive safe out there, stay warm, and we'll see you back here tomorrow morning at 7 a.m.
Mm-hmm. Have a great day. Thank you for watching.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.